Hi, my name is Hamid Ould-Brahim. I'm a product manager at Nokia. I'm going to show you here an interesting use case where we address the problem of handling and resolving congestion in the network using traffic analytics provided through a company we just acquired called Deepfield. So I'm going to show you a combination between two products that act on the network. One gets the information from the network, which is Deepfield, and the other one acts on the network using carrier SDN techniques represented through the Nokia Network Services platform. So we call this use case inside-driven. Inside means inside the understanding the traffic, the visibility of this traffic on the peering point. So this use case has actually two options. Options one will focus on the peering node experiencing the congestion problem and tries to redirect selected traffic per application to an alternate peer. And option two tells you that if there is congestion on the peering, like here node 35, we can act at the edges of the network by establishing a tunnel from node 32 to 35 and redirecting that tunnel to node 35. By using segment routing technology. So now we go to the NSP, we go to the application that implements inside optimization, inside-driven optimization and automation. In this case, I'm presented NSP is peering with node 32, 33, and 35. The node that is experiencing congestion is node 35, so I'm going to that node and I will show you how we try to understand the traffic in that node and then steer some of the traffic from that node. So in this case, I go to setting. I need to use Deepfield to auto-discover the site. So I will say discover new site. And as you can see, I'm already discovering the sites here, Apple, Netflix, Sky, Verizon, and so on. So I go back to the router 35. Now it select Netflix traffic and move them to alternate peer. So in this case, I get all the site name, all the real-time bandwidth, and I have five subnets here. If I click on them, I can see all the routes associated with that particular site. For example, Netflix has five. So in this case, and I can even click on them, and I can see all the details of the interface. So if I go back and I steer the traffic of Netflix, so I will say steer traffic. It shows me all the routes, say continue, the next hop will be node 39. I say continue, I verify the policy. When I click finish, it means it's active, means all Netflix traffic has been redirected to the alternate peer. And if I go to the port itself, I can track whether traffic has been effectively redirected. So I can see the real-time port utilization on that particular node 39, for the node 39, and each 10 seconds, this plotter will tell me whether traffic is going high. So it starts collecting live data for Netflix. So as you can see, now we hit 20% of the traffic. So this is phase one of the options. And we offer within phase one and two the ability for the customer to go to Deepfield directly from NSP, and then they can understand the traffic, generate reports according to the use case that we had before. So here I'm going to Deepfield and I will show you, Deepfield will provide you his Netflix traffic, how much traffic on this particular route, and I can add whatever report I want to generate. And here, for example, I have 51% of traffic for this address of Netflix. It was moved and so on. I can even produce, more interesting information here about the use case. This is coming directly from Deepfield. Let's see now how to use option two, which is using segment routing to redirect traffic to an alternate peer. So in this case, I go to the router that is 32, and I go to that router, I go to the steering menu, and in this case, I can see all the site names. So I will create an RSP from that site to the node 35, so which we call Netflix tunnel number two, for example, number three. And then in this case, I select the PCC address related to the PSAP protocol. It's 32. I select the source address 32, the destination 35, the profile that shows how the traffic, how that LSP characteristics are 0. When I said save, it created the LSP from 32 to 39. So to see it, I go to our path controller. It's going to show you the real-time topology, and just as you can see, that LSP has been created. I can hover over it, and it tells me exactly what nodes that LSP is traversing. Once I've done this, now I'm able to go and steer traffic, Netflix traffic, to that alternate LSP. So I click steer, continue. So this time I will pick Netflix, steer all Netflix subnet like I did before, but this time I select LSP, and I will select the new LSP that created, Netflix tunnel. I click continue, finish, and it's done, which means all traffic Netflix is going through that tunnel to that particular peer and then to the alternate peer. Also, I showed you how we can use carrier SDN with traffic analytics and combine them together to realize this intelligent use case for resolving congestion. So thank you for your attention.